This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. We're going to solve this rational inequality on this video. Make sure you've already watched the intro to solving rational inequalities, and before that, my videos on solving nonlinear polynomial inequalities. Before we begin, let's just look at the steps again. We're going to write the inequality with a zero on one side, then we're going to write as a single fraction on the other side, and then we're going to factor numerator and denominator and go from there. So let's just start with making sure for our problem we have a zero on one side and we write as a single fraction on the other side. So notice there's no zero here, so what I'm going to have to do is subtract 2 from both sides. Now I'm going to give you a little hint here. Since we're eventually going to write it as a single fraction, it will be easier if you have the same denominator on each side. Okay, so notice 2 is the same thing as 2 over 1, so I'm going to show you two ways to do this. You could simply just go minus 2, less than or equal to 0, and then get a common denominator, or another way, which I think a lot of people find it easier to make less mistakes with positive and negative numbers, is think of this as 2 over 1 and multiply on the right by x minus 1 over x minus 1 so that I'll have the same denominator on each side first. So then that becomes 2x minus 2 over x minus 1. Now I need to write this with a common, with 0 on one side. It doesn't matter if you put the 0 on the left side or the right side. Most people are used to putting it on the right side, so I'm going to do it that way. But we got to be careful. We're subtracting 2x minus 2 over x minus 1 from both sides, and don't forget, you have to distribute that minus sign through that whole numerator. So that numerator will become x minus 2x plus 2 when you distribute your minus sign, all over x minus 1. So this gives me negative x plus 2 over x minus 1 is less than or equal to 0. Now you could have done the same thing over here, but you have to be really careful with your minus signs, that's all. So when you have 2, you could still write this as 2 over 1, still multiply this by x minus 1 over x minus 1 less than or equal to 0, but don't forget, you're distributing a negative 2 through, and that's the important part here. So you'd have negative 2 times x, so this basically becomes negative 2x, right? And a negative 2 times a negative 1 here is going to be a plus 2. So you have to be really careful with your positive and negative signs here. Now if I add the numerator, notice you're still going to get x plus negative 2x plus 2. So you're still going to get in the numerator negative x plus 2 over x minus 1 is less than or equal to 0. So there's a lot of algebra just to do that second step, which is to make it over a single fraction on one side with 0 on the other side. All right, so now from here, let's see where we go. So here is what we've got. Negative x plus 2 over x minus 1 is less than or equal to 0. We're going to go ahead and I think I'm going to move this onto another page so we have a little bit more space. All right, here was our original. X over x minus 1 is less than or equal to 2. We have a single fraction, and then it says to factor. Well, the numerator can't be factored any further, and the denominator can't be factored any further either. People do interesting things at this point. I'm just going to leave it in this factored form. Negative x plus 2 is one factor, and x minus 1 is the factor in the denominator. Of course, negative x plus 2 can be written as 2 minus x. negative x plus 2. If you'd like, you could write that as 2 minus x. That's perfectly fine. That's up to you. So what do? For our next step, we're going to set each factor equal to 0. So negative x plus 2 equals 0, or x minus 1 equals 0. That's going to give us our critical points. And I'm just going to put the x on the other side of the equation by adding x to both sides. So x is 2, or here x is 1. And now we have to decide which one of those, if any, has a circle or a dot on it. All right, so x minus 1 was in the denominator, so remember, x can never be 1, so we're definitely going to put a circle on that. But is 2 a solution? So look at the original inequality up here at the top. If I put in 2 for x, I have 2 over 2 minus 1. Okay, so in other words, if I plug in 2, I'd have 2 over 2 minus 1 less than or equal to 2. So you have 2 over 1 is less than or equal to 2. Is that true? Certainly, because it's equal to 2. So 2 is the solution. The reason is because that's the critical point that came from the numerator, and it has a less than or equal symbol. So just keep in mind, here we're going to put a dot. This one we're going to put a circle on. Okay. So now, let's draw our number line and do our critical points. I got some room over here, so I'm going to do it over here. All right, so my critical points are at 1 and 2. So I'm going to kind of make big spaces here. Let's say that's 1 and that's 2. You can see where 0 is, you know, over here, right? But that's not really necessary. You don't have to do that. So we have a dot on 2 because that is a solution, and we have a circle on 1 because that is not a solution, and this breaks it up really into two pieces. 0 is not one of the critical points, so if it confuses you to put that here, just take it off. You can later put it in again. So we want to pick points to the left of 1, so let's do some test points to the left of 1. How about 0? That's always easy. And you could plug it into the original inequality or this factored one, really doesn't matter, to see if it's true. I'm going to go ahead and do it into this right here since that's easy to look at. So we're going to plug in 0. So if you put in 0 for x, the numerator is 2, which is a positive number. And the denominator, when you put in 0, is the negative 1, which is a negative number. So positive divided by negative is negative. So it's negative in that region to the left of 1. Now let's pick a number in between 1 and 2. Let's test 1.5, for instance. So I'm going to put in 1.5 for x. So I have negative 1.5 plus 2. That's still a positive number. And in the denominator, I have 1.5 minus 1. That's positive as well. And a positive divided by a positive is positive. And then to the right of the 2, let's test 5, for instance. So I'm putting in 5 for x. So negative 5 plus 2. That's a negative number. And in the denominator, negative 5 minus 1, that's a negative 6. So that's a negative number. Oops, I'm sorry. I'm putting in 5. 5 minus 1 is a positive number. Negative divided by positive is negative. In general, you probably notice these usually keep changing signs unless you have something squared. All right, so I tested it in here. It's always a good idea to go ahead and test it in the original. So like if you put in 5 into this original inequality, for instance, 5 over 5 minus 1 less than or equal to 2, does that give me a true statement? Is 5 fourths less than or equal to 2? And it's true, and that's what we want, because we want that it is less than or equal to 0 when we are testing this particular way, right? When we put it in the original, we're just saying, does this make the inequality a true statement when I plug in 5? So in any case, we're going to have the solution where it's less than 0 that I put up here. to the numbers less than 1 or greater than or equal to 2. So my solution in interval notation, negative infinity up to but not including 1, so it's parentheses, union, and it goes from 2 until infinity. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.